Here I am in my Contoso Sales Analytics workspace, and in this task flow, you can see we've built a full end-to-end solution here in Fabric. It has everything from data ingestion, to our data stores, to machine learning and AI, to data visualization, and even real-time alerting and dashboards. Now I need to make some updates to our solution, and I'm going to show you how I can use Copilot everywhere across Fabric to be more productive. But first, I'm going to use the built-in Git integration in Fabric. The Git integration in Fabric is now GA, and we also have new support for items from the real-time intelligence workload. So I'm going to create a new branch workspace to do my work. I just give it a name, and automatically Fabric will create a new workspace and branch and sync it with my Git repo. So I can make all my updates and verify my changes without disrupting my current solution. In a few moments, all of the supported workspace items have been added to the new workspace. Now, what I want to do is update the data warehouse we're using for our customer loyalty program to include data about the orders our members are making. To do this, I'm going to create a new data pipeline. Let's give the pipeline a name, and I'm ready to go. Now, instead of manually creating the pipeline activities, I'm going to use the new Copilot for data pipelines that is now in public preview. With this Copilot, I can use natural language to simply tell Copilot what I need done. In this case, I want to copy the orders table, and I can select the connection I want to use from the built-in UX and tell it to put the data into a new table in my data warehouse. I also want to get an email if the pipeline fails. So I send this to Copilot in the chat, and just like that, Copilot has created the pipeline activities I need. And now I can run the pipeline and start moving the data over. Using natural language to configure my pipeline is much faster than using UX. And if I give the data some time to load, I can switch back to my data warehouse and refresh it and see my new table. And the new Copilot for data pipelines can do a few other cool things as well. If I switch over to the monitoring hub and select a different pipeline activity that has a failure, such as this Databricks data load, I can ask Copilot to help me understand what's going on with the error. Copilot will look at the error codes for me, so I don't have to go searching on my own, and help me understand what's going on. In this case, it looks like there might be a quota issue that's causing a problem, and Copilot has given me a few links where I can learn more. Okay, so let's switch back to my warehouse. Now, I'm going to use Copilot in data warehousing, which is also now in public preview. Let's start by asking Copilot to recommend some queries I might want to run. In here, Copilot has looked at my data and made some query suggestions. Let's look at the top three primary interests of customers who have backordered items, which I can now ask because we've brought in the additional orders table. And I can run the query and see the result. It looks like camping is the area with the most backorders. Now let's ask Copilot to create a bit more complicated query. Let's ask for a view of customers who have backordered orders, their lifetime value, how many backorders they have, and group it by their primary interests. And Copilot has generated the query, which I can run and create the view. Being able to use Copilot to generate SQL is not only a huge productivity boost, but it's also great for helping people upskill and learn to take on more challenging tasks. All right, next, let's create a new report, which I can do right from my data warehouse using Power BI's Direct Lake mode. Again, with Copilot, I can simply ask for what I want, such as a breakdown of customer lifetime value and backorders. And in a couple of seconds, Copilot has generated a report page, and it's a great starting point for building out a full report on my data. So now I've used Copilot integrated across Fabric to get data, to work with it in my data warehouse, and visualize it in Power BI. And finally, I can switch back to my workspace, open my source control pane, and commit my changes, with everything seamlessly integrated end to end.